Welcome to the demonstration video for the Next Generation 911 Maturity State Self-Assessment Tool. The Microsoft Excel-based tool will help you assess the NG911 maturity state of your Emergency Communication Center, ECC, or Public Safety Answering Point, PSAP, as defined by the Task Force on Optimal PSAP Architecture. Along the way, the tool will help administrators, oversight personnel, and public safety officials learn about critical NG911 elements and develop NG911 transition steps. Using this tool is a team effort and might involve vendors as well as your agency's technical staff. There are no right or wrong answers, and the results of the tool will not be shared unless you choose to do so. Let's begin with the first tab, which contains an introduction and instructions on using the tool. For your reference, the definition for an ECC/PSAP is listed, along with links to additional NG911 resources. The second tab contains the core of the tool. The self-assessment is a series of questions that characterize the maturity state of your ECC/PSAP. First, select one of three ECC/PSAP types: regional, state, and local. The questions in the tool are tailored to address specific requirements and issues associated with each type. If you're with another kind of agency, please select the type that best describes the jurisdiction of your agency. After selecting your ECC/PSAP type, you will move on to the governance section. Governance encompasses 911 oversight authorities and the tracking of planning and implementation efforts. If you're not familiar with a particular category or element, don't worry. Simply click on a term and you'll be taken to a definition or explanation in the Elements Descriptions tab. There is also a complete list of the acronyms used in the tool in the Acronyms tab, along with their definitions. The section after governance addresses NG911 architecture, which refers to service elements and components. After architecture is security, which refers to 911 security capabilities and operations. Column A contains the numbers of each question. Column B contains the self-assessment questions. Column C contains the multiple choice options, which are visible when you click the sub. Choose the option that best characterizes your ECC/PSAP. Each option corresponds to a maturity state, visible in column D. Some questions do not correlate to a specific maturity state, as you can see here. However, they are included to assist with your transition to NG911, so answer them accordingly. The tool has many embedded text descriptions and terms as well. To view them, simply hover over the red triangle comment indicator, like this. For example, here you see a description of multi-jurisdictional cooperation. Once you've answered all the questions for one section, an aggregate maturity state will appear at the bottom of the section. The aggregate maturity state will always be the lowest reported maturity state in the section, following the logic that a chain is only as strong as its weakest link. The aggregate maturity states of all sections will consolidate into the overall maturity state, located at the top of the self-assessment tab. Following the same logic from before, the overall maturity state will always be the lowest reported aggregate maturity state. You have the option to export the completed file into Adobe Portable Document Format, or PDF. Clicking this button will automatically save the PDF in your Documents folder under the same name as the Microsoft Excel sheet. The NG911 Maturity State Self-Assessment Tool is a great resource to determine your ECC/PSAP's maturity state and to help plan the necessary next steps in your NG911 transition. Please direct all questions and comments to the NG911 Working Group, NG911WG@hq.dhs.gov.